graphic audio. A movie in your mind.
Impending sense of doom? No. Why?
Graphic Audio and Archie Comics present Archie, Volume 6, by Mark Waid, with Ian Flynn and Audrey Mock. Narrated by Robb Moreira and Bradley Foster Smith, and performed by a full cast.
Chapter 1. Riverdale's The Bachelor.
Ladders are set up on the basketball court in the gymnasium of Riverdale High School. Banners and streamers are being hung around the space. Archie Andrews, thankfully, is not up on one of those ladders or anywhere near them. His pal, Kevin Keller, made sure of that. Archie finishes blowing up a balloon, somehow shaped like a cube, and attempts to tie it.
Welcome back. Things have been pretty quiet since last time.
All around Archie's feet are inflated cones, pyramids, stars, shapes that should be physically impossible for a normal balloon.
The big spring dance is coming up, and since I've got a lot of time on my hands, I volunteered to help set things up.
Kevin Keller comes over to check on Archie and stares in disbelief at the physics-defying balloons.
How?
Arch doesn't notice him, still trying to tie the cube.
Why do I have so much time on my hands? Betty and Veronica have both blacklisted me. Yeah, I've tried to move on, but...
Archie's attempt to tie the cube balloon is a failure. Just like his recent attempts to date other girls, something always managed to go spectacularly wrong. A nice candlelit dinner led to a fire. A bouquet of fresh roses led to bees. A nice bicycle ride through the park led to, well, here she is now, her arm in a sling, sitting in a booth at Pop's Chocolate Shop, commiserating with two of Archie's other dates.
How?
The girl without eyebrows sitting beside her shakes her head.
I told you. I tried to warn you.
We know.
Another girl, her face dotted with adhesive bandages covering bee-sting welts, nods.
How could we say no, though? Archie's cute, sweet, supportive, can play guitar.
But it's like his bad luck aura infects you the minute you get too close.
Betty and Veronica seemed okay.
Veronica got shipped off to boarding school a world away, and Betty was driven off a cliff. She only survived Archie because she's tougher than iron.
The girl with her arm in a sling raises her milkshake glass.
Well, we learned our lesson. No more Archie.
Cheers!
Unseen by the girls, Archie slinks down in an adjacent booth, looking absolutely miserable. He lets his forehead hit the table. His pal Jughead sits across from him, behind a plate stacked high with cheeseburgers.
What am I gonna do, Jug? The two girls who were my world won't talk to me, and every other girl treats me like a walking curse.
Do, and I'm just throwing this out there to protect half the student body, literally anything else.
Archie slowly raises his head with an unimpressed scowl.
You're a big help, you know that?
Wisdom earned is twice as valuable as wisdom dispensed. I'm doing you a favor by not solving your problem for you.
Help me.
Seriously, Arch. Read a book, play a video game, write an album, find another junk car and slowly kill it.
I've got no ambitions and all that just came off the top of my head.
I know, but those all just feel like distractions.
Better than moping.
Yeah, I guess.
Archie digs out his phone from his pocket. The display reads 0 messages.
Chapter 2. Dear Veronica.
Meanwhile, Betty Cooper and Veronica Lodge are dressed in robes, laying side by side on plush massage chairs in the Lodge Manor spa room. Their faces are slathered with green exfoliating paste, and their eyes are covered with thin slices of cucumber.
How are you feeling? Isn't this simply divine?
I don't know. I appreciate being pampered.
Betty sits up, peeling the cucumbers off her eyes.
But I'm used to eating cucumbers, not wearing them.
She takes a towel and wipes the paste off her face.
So, now that we're good and relaxed, should we address the less than graceful elephant in the room?
Veronica lies perfectly still, her face inscrutable behind the green mask and cucumber eyes.
I haven't the slightest idea what you're implying, dear.
5'9", Goonie smile, once destroyed your house.
I got you the first time, sweetie.
Veronica sits up and wipes her face clean.
You won, you know? I've been keeping away so you two can be happy.
I appreciate the lack of drama. Seriously, but...
Betty looks over at her crutches, leaning against the wall.
I honestly can't tell if he wants to be with me or to make up for the accident, still.
When did he become so... complicated?
I know, right? It has me second and triple guessing going to the spring dance. I want to go, but going with anyone at this point.
Betty had recently turned down not one, but two offers to go to the dance. Dilton Doily and Archie Andrews.
I don't know what to do.
Veronica holds out her hand.
Darling, you're Betty Cooper. You can do anything.
Betty takes Ronnie's hand, and she eases out of the massage chair. Veronica steadies her as they head over to a large vanity.
I, on the other hand, am not nearly so hardy. I have no interest in seeing anyone right now, but I simply cannot be seen at a social event on my own.
Ronnie, it's Riverdale. You could show up in something from, do not shriek with horror, last season, and no one would bat an eye.
Veronica shakes her jet black hair free from the towel.
Very true. I've come to find our classmates' barbarisms quaint, endearing even.
Plus, you'd be passing up a social engagement and leaving Cheryl Blossom unchallenged for attention.
Absolutely not. I cannot afford to let her gain any territory.
Atta girl.
Betty looks at her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.